There's just too many action figures and not enough time to make reviews for all of them. I got plenty of time to show them all off though. So
let's do this.
So it's really unfortunate for me that when Dow Sim came out, so did Bison, and I didn't get them until maybe 5 months after everybody else. And by that time, there was just so many new figures dropping that he just kind of fell by the wayside. Fans of the channel know, and anybody new who's watching, Jetta Toys are my jam and jelly. They are the business. I think they're one of the best toy companies out there to date. It sucks I'm not reviewing more of their figures. I swear that I will. But Dow Sim is so fire. The accessories he's coming with, I mean, they are just top of the line. The only thing I would say is that I wish this hand would have been able to come out so you could swap out the different hands. But I understand the fist is the move with the hand and the arms, whatever it is. But let's just get real. Jetta Toys kills it. Everything about this is just gorgeous. Like, the articulation is spot on perfect. Jetta Toys produces some of the best articulated bucks that you can possibly get. I can only imagine where they're going to go in the future, but what I like most about these figures is it's just how effortless it is to get into a pose. And you can hit any pose. Every pose you can get them into looks great. It just hits every way you look at it. Pun intended. Get. How about we douse him and light him because he's fire? Hiya! Hiya! Bam! Snake Eyes and Timber. I picked this up from Ollie's like at the beginning of the year for like, I think it was like 10 bucks. And bro, full disclosure, not the biggest G.I. Joe fan. I'm not trying to build some certain team or a group. I don't care about a certain outfit. If it looks cool, then that's what it is. I know it's not the traditional Snake Eyes outfit. I dig the pants though, man. Like, I dig the military ninja look. It's just different and it's fire as shit. I know that this is an older buck from the pins alone, but the articulation, man, it's so good. This is the ultimate way to have neck articulation. I wish everything that Hasbro did, they put a neck like this on it. It would just add so much more to every figure. It's just the posability, man. It just looks so good. He is so great. Timber is equally as amazing. I mean, the articulation in the joints, it's just ridiculous. Snake Eyes comes with an astounding number of accessories too. I'm not gonna break them all out. I'm not gonna go into all that. It's just such a good set. And I couldn't be more happy to have Snake Eyes finally added to my small but ever-growing collection of G.I. Joe figures.
So onward we go, noble steed.
Bink. So Jack-O-Lantern already showed up on one of my previous top 10s, but I don't really want to stop talking about this figure because, man, he was just a sleeper hit. Dropping the same times as Cyclops on the same buck, and everybody was just flabbergasted with that Cyclops figure. I mean, the figure's good, but that face was dog shit.
First, the goat. He's a fancy lad, isn't he?
Are you guys leaving without me?
An absolute abomination.
But man, like, everybody just passed this figure up, and I, you know what? I'll take this one over Cyclops any day, because he's so much fun, man. His glider is fantastic, even though it's just one solid color and it's kind of cheap and stuff, but it works because
I said it does.
Now, the fun factor goes up a lot whenever you treat him like a snowboarder, skateboarder, skier. Really get into some awesome different kind of trick shots like that. So, I mean, just amps up all the different toy photography you want to do, bro. It's just such a good figure. Another great idea for Jack-O-Lantern.
Make him a B-boy, bro.
Ew. Man, there's nothing wrong with Green Goblin, Hobgoblin, Demo Goblin. They all got their gliders and stuff, but none of them have like a platform base. It's just, man, if people just use their imaginations and their thought process, bro, you can come up with some cool shit with this character, man. I'm telling you, this is a star standout. And if you don't think so, that's fine. But I do, and that's what it is. Growing up in the 80s and 90s, there were three G.I. Joes that were my absolute favorite G.I. Joes. It was Gnawhide, Eel, and Rescue. I'm going to make a video for this figure. It's not going to be a full review. It's more than likely going to be fun and for 4 minutes. But any way you look at it, stay tuned for that. It'll be dropping sometime in the future. But anyway, Scooch. Just look at all these accessories, man. Like, he comes stacked with all different kinds of crazy shit. So many options. And stay tuned for that video because I'm going to be going through a lot of different swaps and kit bashes and stuff you can do with this badass. Just this Warthog alone, bro, like, I can't wait until Hasbro starts making a lot more animals so you can start kitbashing and swapping around different parts from them to make them different obscure, like, Island of the Dr. Moreau type of creatures and shit. Bro, I'm all for this. But yeah, dude, any action figure I had growing up as a kid that gets any kind of a modern update, I'm gonna have to pick that shit because it just works out too well. And man, why not relive childhood as an adult, you know what I'm saying? He did always remind me of the bad guy from Rescuers Down Under. dope movie callback.
Shout out.
Number 4. We're giving it to Pretty Boy. Ultraman was already in the top 10 previously, but I wanted to keep them together because they pair well together. With Ultraman here, speaking of B-Boy. And I know that's not the head that came with it. This is a fine head. I really dig it. The 80s aesthetic, the Bruce Campbell Army of Darkness look-alike kind of thing going on. Any 80s or 90s goofy hair, sign me up. But bro, the whole reason I wanted to get them was for kit bash and customs. Like, it is perfect to swap out heads, especially if you got this head. Sure, the body's kind of basic and stuff. It's just one pretty much just solid color with a generic robot kind of design, but it fits and works. It looks dope. Added a belt to him and whatnot. I'm not going to get too much into a kit bash kind of thing with it, but man, the figure's fire for what he is. The two hands he comes with, an extra set of hands. Sorry, my bad. The pistols, bro, he is good. He's been the subject of a few shorts and videos too, so check those out on my TikTok and YouTube and Instagram and everything else. But he is figurative fire. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm gonna get flagged.
We have arrived at the halfway point.
So I know this guy's a Cantina band member, and that's absolutely it. Let me say, I'm not the biggest Star Wars fan. I clearly recognize who these are and stuff, though, but I didn't want them for the band. I thought these would be a better army builder, and I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. Like, these things are so poseable. I did a little bit of extra Dremel on the inside to give him a little bit more forward crunch. I'm definitely not doing a band thing with this guy. If this is how they would have sold the promo pics, I think this figure would have been way more sought after, I guess. More people would have picked him up. But bro, he looks really intimidating in this pose, man. Like, kit bash possibility, Danny Ketch. I know it seems strange, but with a little bit of maybe some sculpt, clearly new head and hands, I think this would be an easy custom Ghost Rider. Vroom, vroom. I did only get him for one reason, and that was to have a smoking friend for Lizard, because this is a bomb, baby. Whee! Yeah, boy. I think I found 66 Batman at the perfect time in my life. During this current, I feel oversaturation of Batman, and the darkness levels continuing to rise to be more gritty and more real. Dude, there's nothing more than a breath of fresh air with 66 Batman, man. Just the fun that he is. It makes me love this show so much. I just got into it during the COVID pandemic when we were all bored doing whatever we were doing. And I love that shit. I didn't know that it was literally Batman and Robin. Batman and Robin is probably one of my favorites just because of how goofy and fun it is. But especially nowadays, I just dig it, man. I just want fun in movies. I'm sick of crying and tears in all these superhero movies. So when I saw him, there's no way I could have passed on him. This is going to be a showcase on the display from now on. And man, it's just $22, bro. You got tons of accessories, tons of hands. You get the wired cape and shit. Ugh. Anyway, there's just something so earnest, I guess, about the show. Like, it's just only meant to be fun. Nothing is to be taken serious. It didn't reflect any current society opinions and political points. It was just made up and fun. Oh man, people should just take a lot of lessons from 66 Batman going forward. But anyway, Commissioner, word to your mother. I love this figure, man. I couldn't have been more thrilled to see it. When I finally got it, I went, I couldn't believe it. The chicken GameStop was even like, are you okay? I was like, yeah, I'm fine. I'm just getting this and getting the hell out of here. There have been so many different designs for the Turtles over the last few decades. I know every collector has their certain little core team and design that they like. For me, it's Mirage Comics and the 90s movies. Those are the two best versions, and these are just the perfect amalgamations of both of those combined together. The detail, man, the accessories, everything about these are on point and
tubular.
This pose is so fire. His body language reads, he does not care and he is not threatened. His face says, you ain't getting Splinter.
These little turds are just so dope.
They're all bodacious and radical in their own individual ways. All their accessories make them unique and individual amongst themselves. And equally together, one of the most impressive team sets I have in my collection.
The one thing that would make them perfect figures is if Mezco were to implement the ball joints for the ankles as well as the wrists. Just a personal opinion.
The Spider-Man from the animated VHS 2-pack with Vulture.
It is fire.
It's very hard for me to want to pass up a classic suited Spider-Man figure. I'll tell you that. No matter what buck. And especially when you're going back to the standard basic articulation with the crunches. Sign me up. The diaphragm swivel up top is ass. It ruins the design of every single costume of a figure that gets put on there because it slices that sucker in half down the middle. I know for sure that this version is really just not liked at all because I've seen nobody talk good things about it so far, but I don't care. I love it. It is a quintessential in my staple. And the reason I like Spider-Man so much is because it's literally the pinless updated version of this Spider-Man. And this is my absolute favorite Spider-Man action figure in my entire collection. He is perfection. The only thing about him is that the head is just a little too big in my opinion. And after swapping out the feet with, I don't know which Spider-Man version it was that has the toe joints, but it's a little loose, so I think I may be going back to just the regular feet that he came with. This figure is just so exceptional in a number of different ways. If anybody wants to see me do a review of him, just shout at me in the comments. If enough people say yeah, then I'll definitely throw it up there. I have no problem talking about Spider-Man for days.
I've reached the top.
Hell yeah, dude. I did not want to make a video for this until I finished with these boot cuts. And now by the time boot cuts are done, hype may be down, but I don't know. Possibility for a video still could come. This is the best buck any Wolverine's ever come on. Any furthering Wolverine needs to come on this body for sure. Hasbro. Do the boot cuts already, though. Shit. And you can literally re-release every single costume of Wolverine that you've ever put out so far just on this body. And you know you're going to make millions of dollars, dude. Jesus. Right amount of accessories. Head sculpt kind of sucks. I'll show a picture.
Ew.
But man, like, I don't know, not enough to be said about this figure, man. It's like, it's perfect in every way for the most part. I love the snarling face. Like, this is easily the best face that Hasbro's ever given us for a masked Wolverine. Man, it looks so good. As much effort as you put into making this face, do that with every figure. It just looks so good. And the stippling, the printing tech doesn't look that bad. It actually looks really good. It looks fire! I love this figure. It is so good. I'm just going to keep spinning it around and just not stop looking at it.
Yeah!
All right, everybody, let's wrap this up. Shout out me in the comments below. Let me know your favorite figures you've picked up this year. And of all the figures you've seen, if enough people comment about a particular figure from the video, I'll do a review for it. Meeting adjourned.